Hi, this is After Effects Basic Training Tutorials. At ngayon, ating pag-uusapan is about 3D integration. It's about time remapping. And the last is rendering or exporting files. Okay, let's go.
Good day, everyone. This topic is about 3D integration. We're going to create 3D layers in After Effects, and we'll see the camera, how the camera works, and then about the lights, and then the depth of field. Okay, so let's import the files. Let's import 4 files. Okay, let's make a new composition. Actually, you can make one composition by just dragging multiple layers. Then you have option. You want a single composition or you want multiple composition. In multiple composition, lahat ng apat na layers na files na nilagay mo, magkakreate siya ng individual composition. Let's try. Ayan. Ito na. So, the problem is hindi siya magdi-display. Kikreate ng sariling view. So, diretso na siya sa project files. So, let's try the single composition. Okay, single composition lang. Para mag di-display siya ng timeline, sa timeline. Okay. So, this is our clip. Trim natin to. Press N, then right click, trim work area. Okay, in After Effects, mostly, ano lang siya, two-dimensional lang siya. The After Effects also has a 3D functionality like this one. Okay, you just click the 3D button. Now you can see the arrow. This is the Y axis, the X axis, and the Z axis. You can move to the left, to the right, and then you can also move the distance. See? So, kung titingnan mo, parang in-scale mo lang siya. In-scale mo lang. Parang ni-resize mo lang siya. Pero actually, it's not resizing. It's moving the clip towards you or away from you, away from the camera. So, meaning it's the distance. Parang ano lang siya. Parang resizing lang siya. So, reset natin lang. Reset information. Okay, let's add a camera. Right click, new camera. So, meron siyang option. Meron siyang mga preset. 24mm, 35mm. Gagamitin natin ano lang, yung 50mm. Click OK. Ayan. So, ito na yung composition camera natin. So, once magkaroon ka ng camera, camera dito sa composition natin, makita mo dito sa tool palette, ano na siya? Enable na siya. Pag wala ka pang camera, naka-disable to ng itong tools na to for yung camera tool. So, ito, naka- enable na. Highlighted na siya. So, tingnan natin yung mga tools na pwede natin gamitin. So, you have yung unified camera. Parang orbit tool din to. Parang orbit yung effects niya. Yung function na. So, we have orbit camera. Let's try. Let's 3D muna natin tong iba. Tapos, solo muna natin to. We just see kung anong mayayari sa orbit. Ayan. orbit tool, parang ano lang, just flying around the clip. Okay, and then next is the track camera. So the camera, mag-move siya, tracking left to right, up, and then dun, pababa. And then we have also the Z camera tool. So ayan. Z camera tool, it allows the camera to move, push in close to the layers. Marami kang layers. So it will go to the layers depende sa pag-animate mo o gaano kalayo yung layers from the camera. Okay? So, now, let's see kung ano ba to. Parang ano lang, parehas lang naman. Wala naman mangyayari. So, let's try to arrange our files. Okay, reset muna natin to. Okay, let's resize para makikita natin kung ano yung effects sa 3D camera. Let's say 40. Okay. Let's pose it forward. Okay. Let's pose it to the side. Click muna natin, naka-solo siya eh. So, ito, let's pose it backward. Ito, backward din. Okay, then this one to the back also. Okay, so this time gamitin natin ulit yung orbit camera tool. Okay, let's see, let's use the orbit camera tool. Ayan. So, makikita natin. So, so, yan yung effects ng 3D. 3D space. So, naka-position na siya. Iba-ibang position na. So, let's try the Z tool. Ayan. Push the camera into towards the layers. Ayan. Okay. Ayan. Let's try to animate. Ay, ito pala yung ano, shortcut. May shortcut pala tayo sa mga tool. Just hit letter C. Ayan. Orbit, yan, track, at saka Z, 2. Okay, let's try to animate. Adjust natin ko na. Okay. Let's go to transform, then let's animate the position. Gamitin natin yung Z tool. Hanggang dito lang sa may 3 seconds. Yan. The camera will push through the second objects. Yan. Lagyan natin yung easy ease. Surrender. Yan. Yan. The camera flies through the layers. Okay? And then here, from the monitor, nakikita natin yung active camera. Tapos meron din siya mga preset view. Custom view, 1, 2, 3, then front, left, top, back, right. And let's click the top view. So, dito, makikita natin. So, ang layo niya. So, adjust mo na. Adjust mo na natin kundi. You can adjust between layers. So, there. Okay. Let's go back to active camera. And then from here, you can adjust also the specific clip. For example, this one, you can adjust the rotation. Adjust mo siyang konti. Aslant siya. Adjust natin yung y-axis. Tsaka ito. So, depende no, sa gusto nyong gawin. Okay. Then let's go to, let's talk about light. So in 3D space we can also add lights. So just right click and then new light. Okay. So pero siyang type of light, we have spotlight. So, katulad ng spotlight na alam natin when we observe in the stage, especially when we attend concert or beauty pageant or any events, no, malaking events. So, gumagamit sila ng spotlight. So, may direction siya. So, ito naman yung point. So, like a bulb. Parang, ano lang siya. Parang ilaw na just to illuminate at the center. And then, the ambient. Actually, you cannot see the ambient light. It just illuminate the whole space. So, ayan yung mga lights na availability. Parallel, meron din. And then, color. You can change to any color you like. So light blue. Okay, and then cast shadows. So cast shadows, naka-click na siya. Click OK. So let's see. Where is the light? Ambient pala lang yung check natin. So let's try the point light. So kaya pala naka disable yung cast shadows. So you can see you also see the ambient light, no? Walang light na makikita mo. It's just illuminate the whole space. So let's try the point light. Kasi dito sa point light, ma-adjust natin yung light, ma-move natin anywhere we want. For example, here, ayan. Makikita natin here. You can move, you can push in, push out from the subject, or from the clip natin. Okay? So, cast shadows. Saan yung cast shadows? So, dito, hindi pa natin makikita yung cast shadows. Kasi, dapat turn on muna natin dun sa mga layers. Let's see. Shortcut AA para sa material options. So, ito yung mga material, ito yung material options. So, naka-off pa siya. Kita mo, naka-off pa siya. So, try natin i-on. Okay. So, this layer. Lapit muna natin. Adjust muna natin ito kunti. It's back to zero. Put it back to zero. And then, we will adjust the light para makikita natin yung shadow. Okay. Again, it is a front. Let's move the light to the right. As you can see, sabihin natin kunti. So, nagda-darken na yung likod niya. So, that means, nag-work na yung shadow. So, yung shadow, siyempre, nagdidepende doon sa source ng light. So, if you move to the right, the shadow moves to the left. Okay, so that's the cast shadow. So anytime you can change the light, the properties, just double click here, you can change the color. And then we can also adjust the shadows properties. Like that, puti, so white. Okay, so let's hide muna natin itong dalawa. And let's focus on the shadows here para makikita natin yung dalawang properties na pwede nating paglaruan. Okay. Let's go to the light. So, ito yun, the diffusion. Ayan. If you bring down the diffusion to zero, kita mo, hard yung shadow na. So, when you increase, so soften yung shadow na. Tapos yung darkness naman, parang opacity siya. So, the higher, the darker the shadow will be. Ayan. Tayo natin i-move. See? So, soften pa natin konti. Ayan. Okay? Alright. So, that's the shadow. Explore mo pa kung ano pang pwedeng magawa based sa project na gusto natin. Okay, let's go to the depth of field. Turn off na natin yung lights. So, okay na, no? Shadow, lights, and then let's go to the depth of field. Off muna natin itong animation. Focus dito, focus tayo dito sa depth of field. So yung depth of field, just like a real camera lens function where you can have a focal plane. So, adjust natin, ha. May focal plane siya. Okay. Tingnan natin to. Oh, let's go to camera. AA. Para makita natin yung options, material options, yeah. So, tingnan natin. So, dito, nakita natin naka-off yung depth of field. So, just turn it on. Ayan. So, naka-blur siya. Possibly, yung lens niya nasa gitna ng dalawang layers natin. So, you can adjust the aperture kung gaano siya ka blurry. Ayan. Then, let's try to adjust the distance, focus distance. Let's add more aperture. 200 maybe. See? So, ngayon, nakapokus na yung sa likod. And you adjust the focus distance. So, ngayon, nakafocus na naman yung harapan. Yan yung tinatawag natin na rock focus. mga film. Ayan. We'll see. So, that's how to use the, how you use the different field. Okay? It's our graph focus effects. Okay. So, that's the 3D integration. So, we have the camera, the different field, we have the light, and then we have the light, different field, and we have the cast shadows. Na pwede nating i-tweak paglaruan once we have a project and we use the 3D integration or 3D effects. Okay. Now let's go to our next topic. Sandali lang, may pahabo lang ako konti. So, in 3D space, you can adjust the its layers. Let's try the to adjust the anchor point. Kasi ito, gagamitin natin to yung sa activity na ibibigay ko. Like yung para siyang book na nag-open. So, you have to adjust the anchor point and that effects. So, dapat nasa gilid siya. Tapos, adjust natin na yung rotation. Parang ganyan. Yan. Open book. So, ganyan. So, animate lang natin pa just for illustration. And then, back to zero. So, para siyang tumatayo from the ground. Yan. Let's animate also the other clip. Adjust the anchor point to the side. Let's add keyframes. Sorry. Balik natin zero yung y-axis niya. Para straight yung pag-animate sa x-axis. Yan. Then, go back to zero. Kaya natin ang easy is para mas maganda. Tapos, lagyan ng motion blur. Lagyan ng animation. Let's go to transform. Practice lang. So from here, zoom in siya. Track Z. Let's move a little bit. Okay. Easy. Yeah. So, yung technique na yan, magagamit natin yan for your activities. Yan. Then, go push to the other layers. Okay. So, I think that's all for the 3D integration. Okay, let's go to the next topic. So, our next topic is time remapping. We get to take a look at speed changes here in After Effects. So, this is our clip. Check muna natin, baka naka-adjust na tong. Balik natin 100%. Ito yung normal speed ng clip natin. Ayan. So, gawin natin slow-mo. Slow natin yung speed up to 50%. So, ang gawin natin, right-click, go to time, and then time stretch. Ayan, yung dialog box ng time stretch. If you type 200, it means it is twice as long as the original clip. So, mag-slow mo siya. If you type 50, baliktad. Fast forward siya. Twice din as shorter as the original clip. So, depende sa application. For example, sa Adobe Premiere, pag gusto mong i-slow mo, so, speed niya, gagawin mong 50%. So, mag-slow mo siya. Gusto mong fast forward, yung speed i-fast forward mo yung clip, gagawin mong 200 or even 500 or 1000. So dito sa After Effects, baliktad siya. So gawin natin 200. So tingnan natin yung naka-slow mo na. Ayan. So naka-slow mo na siya. It is now half the speed from the original clip. So ang ginagawa ng After Effects para maso-slow mo siya, dinoduplicate niya yung every frame niya. Tingnan natin ano nangyayari. I-page down ko. Move, may movement siya. The next clip, the next keyframe, so wala. May movement, walang movement. Pero yung time current time indicator, nagmo-move na siya. So meaning the same frame lang to, dinoduplicate lang niya. So, yan yung process pag sa pag so-slow mo niya. Time stretch ng After Effects. So, yan yung process niya. Dinoduplicate niya yung every frame. Okay? And now, meron din siyang other ways of other ways to process speed changes. First is frame blending. So ito siya. Ito yung button na to. Once you click this, tingnan natin. You see? Mas ano siya, smoother siya. Ah, so mas smooth siya. Ang problema, yung process niya is between frame 1 and frame 2. So mag-blend siya ng i-blend niya yung frame 1 at frame 2 to 50% opacity or so. So blend niya together sa gitna ng frame 1 and frame 2, yung frame 1 at frame 2. So ito nangyayari. Yan. Parang ghosting. Yun yung effect ng blending together frame 1 and frame 2 to 50% opacity. Pero mas softer siya, tingnan, kesa original na time stretch na ginamit natin. Proseso. Okay? Then the number 2 is the pixel motion. So ginawa ng pixel motion, it allows the frame to blend based on their motion. So based sa action niya na nangyayari. Instead of blending frames together, it actually ina-analyze niya yung frame and create an intermediate frame. So unique yung every frame niya. So click mo lang pangalawa. So ayan. Render natin. Anong difference? Ayan, see? Even smoother than the frame blending. So mas smooth siya kaysa dalawang process. So, meron tayong hindi masyadong nakikita dito. It's actually morphing. Nagmo-morph siya. Tingnan mo yung kamay. Kamay at saka paa. See? Pero, hindi na yan halata. Pag tinitingnan mo, mas ano siya. Mas fine siya. Okay? So, that's the pixel motion. Mas okay siya. Unique yung every frame niya. Okay. That's time stretch. Slow motion. Okay? So, let's go to time remap. So, another way to speed changes is time remapping or speed ramp. So, from fast forward to biglang slow motion. So, yan yung effect ng time remapping or speed ramp. So, gagawin natin, balik natin sa normal, 100%. Okay? So, ito yung default speednya. So let's do speed ramp. Right click, go to time, and then enable time remapping. So ang gagawin natin, gagawa tayo ng keyframes. So depende sa gusto natin kung saan natin gusto i-speed ramp siya, i-fast forward, and then saan natin gusto i-slow mo. For this example, so gusto ko mag-fast forward siya, speed up siya from here, this keyframes to here, and then add keyframes, and then from this keyframe up to here is slow motion. Ayan. So next keyframes. So let's adjust, and then let's see what happened. What will happen here? Okay. So let's adjust. Let's move the keyframes, the last keyframes. Na natin. Yeah, see? So that's time remapping or speed ramp. So from fast forward, then biglang nagsuslow motion. Very fine yung transition na from fast forward to slow motion. Okay, that's all for time remapping. Now let's go to the next topic. And now let's go to the last topic. So, let's say, tapos na kayo sa project niyo. Meron kayong title blocks, meron kayong lower thirds, meron kayong for credits. So, ang gagawin natin, render. Export into video files. Okay? So, first, you go to composition. And then, add to render queue. Here. This one, render setting, meron siyang output module, then output 2. So, this output 2, this is your destination. Saan mo siya gustong i-save? At saka, siyempre, yung file name. And then, the render settings, current settings, DV, draft settings, best settings na. So, huwag mo nang pakialaman yan. Ito yung importante. Kasi, andito yung format ng files, it's either AVI, QuickTime, or any format. It's 264 codecs. So, dito tayo mag-a-adjust. So, click natin itong useless. Ayan, here. Here are the format. IEF sequence, JPEG sequence, MP3, PNG sequence, ng QuickTime, Targa. So, click natin yung QuickTime. So, I suggest you use QuickTime format. Mas okay siya. And then here, from the codec, Apple ProRes, DB, meron siya. Mas okay kung may X264 na codec format. Yun ang gagamitin natin. Mas ano siya, mas popular siyang ginagamit sa iba ding mga editors. So, click mo lang yan. Tapos audio, kung gusto nyong mag-export ng audio, pwede rin, turn on nyo lang yung audio. So usually, para sa akin, yung mag-final kasi ako, doon na sa Premiere mostly kasi mag-a-add pa ako ng mga effects. Mas madali yung mag-add ng effects. So, dito, yung ginawa kong audio dito, para ano lang, parang guide lang siya para sa animation ko. For example, gagawa ko ng title blocks. So, ito yung tips na ibibigay ko sa inyo. So, dapat, before kayo gagawa ng animation project para sa isang title blocks or kahit anong projects na pwedeng ipapagawa sa'yo for Hope Channel or for the institutions, reports or promo video or infomercial, mas okay kung meron na kayong music na gusto nyong gamitin para sa certain project na yan. Kasi, once mag-animate na kayo, okay na yung animation nyo, problema yung timing. So, kung huli na yung music, patay kayo sa timing. So mag-a-adjust na naman kayo. Move the keyframes from here to there. So it will take time. So yan yung tip ko. Get the music first. Before you have a script or you have an idea, collect your materials, pictures, video, any graphics, materials, particles, or mga elements na gusto nyong gamitin, tapos music na. So, before kayo mag-start, meron na kayo yan. Meron na kayong materials para yung paggawa nyo tuloy-tuloy na. So, importante yan. Collect mo na yung materials, kasama na yung music. Para pag gagawa na kayo ng project, tuloy-tuloy na yung adjustment, diretso na. Okay? So, very important yan para maging efficient tayo. Hindi masayang ang oras natin. And then, ano na, click OK. Then, na, render. Tuk. And then done. Okay? And then, another tip. Kasi yung Adobe, meron siyang sariling Adobe Media Encoder. So, ang ginawa, ano siya, separate siya. Standalone siya. So, once gagamitin natin siya dito sa After Effects, so, mag-open siya, sarili niyang window. So, kahit sa, ano, kahit sa CS na series, meron ng Adobe Media Encoder. So, mas ano siya, very, ano siya, helpful siya sa trabaho natin, papagaan yung trabaho natin. Kasi, siya na bahalang mag-render doon. You can go back to your project. Especially pag busy kayo, marami kayong pinapagawa sa inyo. So, render nyo siya sa Adobe Media Encoder. Kahit kayong nag-i-edit ng Premiere, meron din. So, makakasave kayo ng oras. Especially pag project nyo mahaba, tapos mabigat. Maraming motion blur, mga particles, maraming layers, matagal i-render, abot ng isang araw, half day. So, dito kayo. Tap, dali lang. So, you can go back to your work, go back to another projects. So, magandang tulong to. Kahit sa Premiere ha, pwede siya. Render mo lang siya doon, then you can go back to your work. Okay? So, I think that's all. Thank you for listening. I hope na nakakatulong ako sa inyo para maka-create kayo ng makagawa ko na yung sarili yung project for the ministry, for the media ministry. Kung saan media ministry kayo nakasako. Okay, thank you very much.